Hi there, Sanjay Gangal from EDA Cafe. I'm here with Stephen Slater, Product Line Manager, Keysight EDA. Hello, Stephen.
Hello there, Sanjay. Very nice to see you again.
Very nice to see you too. Thank you so much for joining us, Stephen. Looks like Keysight EDA is unveiling a new chiplet PHY designer. Tell us about that.
Yeah, sure. So it's been a very big year for the chiplet ecosystem in general. What with Open Compute and also the UCIe consortium, coming together and helping to standardize the I/O, the interconnect between die to die, so between from one chiplet to another chiplet. And in doing so, our customers need the ability to be able to check the signal integrity of the channel that's in between from one die to another die. So, and these UCIe, which is the standard that's been ratified, as it's developing, it's a very wide bus. You can have 64 data lines wide. And so in order to maintain good signal integrity, even though it's a very short channel, you need to be able to simulate all of the signals and make sure that, as the clock goes from one die to another die, that, you've got nice open eyes at the other end. And so that's something that we've created is a simulation solution very much dedicated to that that digital standard. It's not the only digital standard, by the way, for chiplet to chiplet. There's also a bunch of wires and several other standards that are kind of competing. But UCIe is the one that seems to have the most energy behind it, or most big name semiconductor companies supporting it.
Okay, and why are chiplets such a hot topic right now?
Yeah, absolutely. So here we're going to discuss the differences between what came before with a monolithic die, just a single large die, and how you'd go and produce those, and how the chiplet philosophy is trying to get us, to continue on the, more than more path. So if I build the slide out a little. Okay, the traditional way you'd have on a wafer multiple dies and different functions on each of the large monolithic dies. So, function A might be, the CPU, function C would be the peripheral I/O, might be something like connecting to PCI Express. You might have some on-die memory and then also power functions as well. But as we move to a more disaggregated chiplet design philosophy, you can split up the wafer into different functions. Each is its own individual chiplet that could be produced. And what you'll see is if, as we go to produce these wafers, we end up with, just through process variation, some areas where the design does not meet spec, then in the past, that would mean that, there were 12 chips that were designed that fit into this particular wafer. Only 8 chips ended up being good and were kept. Mm-hmm. And so therefore, you'd end up with a yield of 67%. But mm-hmm. with the chiplet design philosophy, same kind of process, same number of, problems, but then you're only throwing away a fewer number of chips. And so therefore the yield comes up. And we can see that actually is as in this age of hyperscalers, in this age of building high performance compute for things like AI, the actual die sizes have been getting bigger and bigger and bigger, and therefore yield is becoming quite a significant issue. And an example would be something like this, AMD being very successful, getting to their large number of cores of for their package CPUs, and showing that by creating individual chiplets that can be put together together with a 12 nanometer I/O die, they were able to keep a product cost scaling. To be very, very preferential. And so this is kind of where the industry is heading. You've got several customers who are really, doing an amazing job at this so far. And what we're kind of hopeful in the industry is that with people moving towards chiplet design, it means that there's a chance for a chiplet ecosystem to start up where inside big companies, they can end up reusing existing designs by designing them as modular chiplets. So internally, providing them for reuse into other, evolutions of a particular design, but then also smaller companies, startup companies, creating chiplets, which could then be integrated into, larger solutions. So I think it's a very exciting time in the industry. Maybe one of the things that we all put an eye towards, though, is that there's obviously some challenges in fabrication and packaging and testing implications as well. So when you test some of these dies as they come together, you really don't want to throw away an expensive, a chiplet for one of the CPU cores because it was packaged together with a much lower cost, chiplet for a smaller function that was bad. So we need to find a way to be able to test and verify chips as they go along, such that when they get packaged together, you're putting in the most expensive die last.
Okay. Are you done with the slides now?
I've got a couple more that just add on to this, okay. And then so
sure.
Okay. So would you like to go to next question?
What are the business opportunities that the chiplets unlock?
Yeah, definitely. I think for various types of industries, such as, for instance, in aerospace defense, we see a lot of interest in aerospace defense companies looking for greater performance and greater security by bringing in, instead of having multiple chips on a printed circuit board, trying to bring them inside the same package. So I think that, it's not just one industry, it's not just consumer electronics or data center that this has possibility for, but even automotive companies are looking at the possibilities of what chiplet may provide in order to bring more compute into a smaller design space. Now, when it comes to simulation EDA tools, there again is a business opportunity for EDA companies like Keysight to be able to come and revolutionize or produce solutions that help you to design application specific simulations like this UCIe interconnect from one die to the other. So this is what it's all about. In order to for this to work, we absolutely need now die-to-die communication or this interconnect. We'd mentioned that UCIe is one of them, and bunch of wires is another competing standard. And there's also an advanced interface bus. It is Keysight's intention that we've built our solution at the moment for UCIe, but then come the summertime, it'll also support a bunch of wires, and then we'll work on AIB after that. And actually, this is one particular customer that's using the solution today. It's Alpha Wave Semi. And what you can see is this is Keysight's solution that we've launched at the top. Think of it as a simulation where you're looking at an abstracted view. So the chiplet die on the left, the chiplet die on the right, which has all the receiver set up. And then what's in the middle is the channel. And the channel you can kind of see here as broken out. So this happens to be a TSMC packaging technology. So it's a chip on wafer on substrate. And you see you've got the TX connecting through to the RX on this die, but then also having the ability to be able to connect, you know, down or, you know, getting the signals off the package as well. The interesting thing that's kind of special to UCIe, they have come up with a new type of measurement or type of specification that's called the voltage transfer function. And what this is, it's looking at trying to maintain, you know, how much loss do you see in the channel, and trying to make sure that the channel itself is staying, you know, providing less loss than the limit. And then the other is looking at crosstalk and taking a look at, you know, the Nyquist frequency. Does crosstalk drop above, you know, creep above the spec line or not? And that's what the voltage transfer function is, something that that is naturally simulated as part of our setup. And what Alpha Wave Semi is doing here is they've run a statistical sweep of the channel and transmit receiver settings, trying to find areas that would cause it to fail. So they're trying to harden their design by making sure that that they stay within compliance.
Okay, and what is different from a design and verification point of view? How are the EDA tools evolving to meet needs of this industry?
Yeah, that's very interesting. I would say that there's probably two main things. You know, one is there's a new set of you know, compliance standards such as this we talked about, this voltage transfer function. That's something that's quite new. So you want the EDA tools to be able to quickly capture that and make sure that it's part of the design workflow that's provided. But the second thing is actually just in the simulation technology itself. So one of the key things we look at is that this is, UCIe is a parallel bus, and therefore the data lines that come across, when you get to the receiver, it actually uses a clock signal that's sent with it, and that clock signal is what's used to time, you know, trigger the receiver sampler. So timing of the you know, the decision threshold, is this a one or is this a zero? And so really what you want to do is you want to be able to, in the simulation, to use that forwarded clock, as it's called, use the waveform of the forwarded clock in order to capture and time the data lines. And that's exactly what the simulator technology in Chiplet PHY Designer, which is a part of Advanced Design System, ADS, that's exactly what it does. So you use IBIS AMI models, very standard modeling type for the transmit and receive. But the very special thing is we use the received waveform for the clock and use that exactly to time the data that's being transmitted. So those are things that kind of need to change. But, you know, effectively, we're providing customers with the ability to look at the interconnect at an abstracted view. So, you know, being able to sweep all the parameters on the transmit side and on the receive side, and, you know, trying to find and make sure that the interconnect is very robust and works together.
Well, Stephen, what is the best way for our audience to find out more about Chiplet PHY Designer on the internet?
Sure. Well, we're going to provide a link in the video, so you should see that below, and you can click and follow to find out more information.
Okay, great. Well, thank you so much, Stephen, for taking time to record this interview. Have a great day and stay safe.
Thank you very much, Sanjay.
Okay, this is Sanjay Gangal from EDA Cafe.